This sleeping doe, his family do miss, but he may just wake with a sweet little kiss.
Oh, that was an anticlimax. Hey guys, welcome to Neighbourshood. Our guest today, Olympia Valance.
Hi. Who wrote this? Ben.
Pretty talented. Paul Robinson has just been arrested. I mean, did you even know that? Paige is in hospital. Does she know that? Paul's been arrested?
I actually didn't. I just told you? You just told me.
Wow. As an acting technique, that's really intelligent because it allows Olympia, as the actress, to be in the moment as Paige.
Yeah, well, I only really read my stuff.
Yeah, I mean, it's good, though. It's a good technique to get everything done.
Or is it a lazy technique?
Nah. Come on, let's...
But when I watch the episodes, it's like... Wow, is this what's going on in the show?
Yeah, it's like a double watch.
It's like, this show's great.
Yeah. I'm a really good actress.
Everyone else is good.
Yeah.
Because I'm watching everyone else's stuff.
Yeah,
you know, I actually didn't even know that Paul was arrested until you just, like, that is serious.
Really?
I've been in the hospital the whole time with John.
In hospital with John Doe, in bed, you had scene after scene after scene. Is this a new character that's coming in as a love interest for Paige?
Well, looks like it, but...
He's very attractive, I mean...
He's not bad.
Up top. Come on, good.
Anyway.
Leave me hanging. Barney Stinson, jeez, come on.
But I was just saying to you before that it's really hard to do scenes where you're not talking to anyone because there's no conversation. It's just like me.
Yeah, I mean, I kind of feel like that in this interview, but hey, whatever. So this character, John Doe, I think you guys are going to get together, but your brother has just died.
Yes, he has.
And you're in hospital trying to pick up. I mean, that's a bit insensitive.
Yeah, well, you know, Paige needs to...
She needs to, you know. She needs... What, like make a new friend or something?
Yeah,
or
that's
like...
exactly what I meant.
Yeah, cool, yeah. No problem. So we jumped on set earlier today and we got some spoilers of some stuff coming up way in the future.
Fun.
Trust me. Olympia has no idea about any of this stuff. But now you guys will, and you guys can, you know, jump on Twitter and let Olympia know about all this cool stuff that's coming on Neighbours.
Hello, Beck.
Hi.
So we're on set.
Yes.
You're actually filming a scene with this gentleman who we're not even allowed to show.
It's like the dentist.
You're allowed to hear? Really?
You're allowed to hear, yeah, yeah.
You can hear
they
my
won't
voice.
Recognize
it's
you.
Like the dentist. Yeah, you can see the back of your head. Oh. You can't see your face.
It's a little bit even more scary. But so you got a relationship with this person right here.
Mm.
Coming up in probably 6 months, and can you tell us anything about this gentleman? He's got a sinister laugh.
Yeah, he's handsome, he's lovely.
His name starts with
MLW.
Interesting.
Mm,
well,
very,
lot
yeah,
to work
I'm
on
not
for
sure.
The fans. Thank you, Beck.
Thanks.
We miss you, Josh. We miss you, Josh.
May you rest in peace.
Oh. Kiss Josh. Goodbye, Josh. He's gone. So we got our fans to send in some tweets. Have you seen the Neighbourshood gossip thing
yes,
we've been doing?
Yes.
So the fans are not very happy about you. Paige and Mark.
Breaking up. I'm not happy.
Are they going to get back together? Are
so.
You not?
I don't know.
Triangle with John Doe and Paige. Anyway, so they've got some things to say.
Yeah.
So you got to pick one that's fake.
Sure.
And the rest are real.
Paige has been an idiot anyway. Being a stupid girl, betraying Mark, never listening to him.
I think she's right on the money.
I prefer Mark and Steph.
Totally.
Always found Paige to be annoying.
Ditto.
Karen.
Ditto. Karen.
Karen, thank you. She's a spoilt little brat.
Paige is a spoilt little brat. He means you.
These are all quite negative.
They are all quite negative. Oh, we've stuffed up. Yeah, they're all real. Did we forget to put a fake one in? Yeah. We had a lot to choose from, actually. that was a good one. Yeah. No, she's been a bit of... Look, you know what? Not everyone can have a universally loved and accepted character on Neighbours.
Like who?
Like Stingray, actually. Stingray was quite well-loved universally by all. I think they're trying to bring him back or something. Have you heard that?
No, I haven't heard anything of the sorts. In fact, I know that he's never coming back.
Another way to go is to try to target a new market, maybe try and take Neighbours and give it to a new audience, like Britain. And what do the British people love? Hey, Toadie. Look, I know I look really familiar, like Stingray, your cousin, but I guarantee you I'm not. I'm actually his twin brother, Lobster. And I'm here from France for a full 3 years. A three-year contract, like a long time. And I'm here to stir things up.
But you don't even sound French.
Oh.
Lobster!
3 years, four.
Hashtag la introduction de lobster.
So we just met Lobster, Stingray's evil twin, from France.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Hey, you got the French colours going on. That's good. Can you do a French accent? Nah, you can't do it. You know we've been pranking everyone on set?
Yes, I did
doing
hear about
some
this.
Little scares. Bruh! Can we scare you at some point?
No, you can't.
Oh, come on. It'll be fun.
No.
Olympia? That's so childish. No, we definitely won't prank you, I promise.
Good.
Attempts, we've been unsuccessful in scaring you, old trap boy. I tried.
Just don't get that scared.
Maybe
I'll get you one day.
Maybe it's your turn. That's a scary looking thing, isn't it?
How's that, guys?
Oh, damn it! Get lost! I was genuinely scared. I'm an easy scare, though.
If you dare do that to me, I may come with a knife and slice your throat open.
Very violent! Yay!
I was joking.
6:30. we got you with the first cake taker.
Yes.
Do you remember that?
Yes.
It was pretty good.
It was a nice cake.
It was yummy. And thank you for being a part of it. That was fun.
That's all right.
Because she was a bit of an idiot that week. And we haven't seen you since. You've been really on top of it. I think you've really, apart from the whole, you know, brother thing and, you know, being with a guy who's basically passed out, you know, you've been doing some really good stuff. So this week's cake taker isn't for you.
Oh, good.
But there is a cake taker out there somewhere.
Who is it?
Who is it? Who could it be? Look down the camera.
Thanks, but Trace is on a diet.
Told you,
Terese
on a diet.
Nah, go away.
Travis, no. You are the cake taker this week. How you going, buddy?
Yeah, well, I'll be better after this.
Oh, big stuff on air last week. No, you can't eat it yet. Oh, I'm going to tell you why.
I'm excited. I'll have a cake.
Tyler's been a huge douchebag this week.
Yeah.
Everyone thinks you're responsible for the hotel explosion. Yeah, because...
No comment.
No, because you weren't around. You were last seen with Chaz in the boiler room.
Yes,
so,
I was.
So, at Torchwood Angel, feeling
Torchwood
worried,
Angel.
Last seen in the boiler room with Chaz. People think you're a big cake taker this week because you might have been responsible for the big explosion, so...
Well, I still might be. You never know.
Sorry, you could be. I'm not actually privy to this knowledge, so I'm talking in...
I'm so excited.
Ignorance. Eat it. Cake taker.
You
want
to go house?
Let's do a Lady of the Tramp.
No, you wish.
Oh, come on. Oh, that would have been so cute.
Where are you going, bro? No.
I even closed my eyes in anticipation.
Mm.
I would have had thousands of women all over the world just be like, oh, I wish I could touch Ben's lips because they've touched Travis's lips. Here, I'll take this plate for you. Don't worry about it, sir.
No, this is great. Oh, a glass of water would be great.
I'm getting lost, mate.
Come on, hurry up.
Haha, these look real. Oh! Oh! Ah, my hand!
They're not real.
Nah, they're not. They're not real. Good acting, though. I nailed it.
Yeah.
Come on, you give it a go. Ah!
Ow.
Ouch. You're so good.
Thanks.
You're really good. Do your hair flick again? Well, thank you for watching Neighbourshood this week. Olympia Valance, thank you so much. Woo! Oh, we've got no studio audience. Didn't have the budget.
We can beat this studio audience and...
And do this?
And do this.
Well, I could probably do both. Let's
maybe
just give
we
you
could
one
also
job.
Grab the camera.
Interesting.
And the boom.
Yeah, yeah.
All in
one. Who needs all of that? Production values. We can't let you leave. Can't finish the show until you give us a really good juicy spoiler of some stuff coming up this week on Neighbours.
Okay. Well, things between Therese and Paul get real cray, and who knows, she might just break the law.
Now, so stuff between Paul and Therese get, like, crazy or crayfish? Cray is a like, short word for...
Like cray.
Crazy?
Crazy.
Crazy. Cool. I'm not as hip these days. But hey, guys, thanks for watching Neighbourshood. We'll see you next week.
Bye.
All right, bye.
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 Stop rolling. Thanks, Olympia. No, you're great. Thanks. And cut.
Bye.
Out.